So here we are with this fiberglass fish cast, which we're going to mold up with silicone, a one-piece silicone mold. I was just showing you the edges there, as the edges of the fish don't run parallel to a straight edge, as you can see in the video there. So I'm going to use aluminium foil tape to run around the edges of the fish and follow those contours on the back. And so we'll build a flange template where the silicone flange can rest onto. So I'm just building up these tape layers and preparing the fish for molding. So I'm carefully doing that and making sure that we seal in those edges so that we don't get any silicone seeping through or leaking through the flange, or where the flange meets the fiberglass fish. So I'm taking my time. Obviously the video is speeded up just to show you there and demonstrate. And so while I'm applying the foil tape, I double check to make sure the foil is stuck nicely onto the fiberglass fish, and also iron out any creases around the fish. I'm using a screwdriver to do that there. And I've got a piece of foam board which I'm going to cut up into pieces, and I'll fit underneath any of the gaps underneath the fish and where I've just put the foil template in. So there I'm cutting up the foam board or foam core, which is quite handy. So yeah, when I fit it behind the foil, sort of building it up where we need to, where the tail is, I put three layers of foam core, and as the tail goes towards the head of the fish, you don't need so many layers. And then I fasten the aluminium foil to the foam board as I go through. So it carefully does it. So yeah, so we're going to make a one-piece silicone mold from this fish in view of making further fiberglass casts or resin casts. And the silicone mold is going to be a one-piece silicone mold, which I've already said. So we're going to put a couple of layers of silicone on the top of the fish. So this is our print part of the mold, so this is going to pick out all the details. So we just mix up the red catalyst there, which starts a curing process with the actual main part of the silicone, which is in the big tub there. And so put two layers down, we drip that on and push it around the fiberglass cast. And after we put two layers of the straight silicone on, we'll thicken up the silicone and put a couple of layers of thick silicone over the top of those two layers, so that'll give us that thickness. And then after that, I put a couple of silicone layers, as we did at the beginning, not including the thickener, just to neaten up the mold, take out any sort of rough edges, which is optional, but I like to keep the mold looking pretty good, type of thing. So there I am mixing up the first layer of silicone. So that's just the catalyst and the silicone. The silicone dries or cures relatively slowly to the other silicones, and I like that because it gives a chance for the air to escape, and I don't have a vacuum chamber at this moment in time to get all the bubbles out. So this is ideal for mixing by hand. And where I'm pouring onto the top of the fish there, I'm pouring from a height, so you get a little stream of silicone, and that should take out all the air bubbles. And then just move it around with a spatula, and I've got a paintbrush there. So I'm just moving moving the silicone around where I wanted, not really painting, but sort of pushing the silicone to where I want it to go. So yes, this is the first layer. I'm taking my time on it. Make sure you get it in all the areas you need it to go. I'm just going into the mouth there, and there's a recess in there. So making sure that's covered, and when we put the thicker layers on, we can fill the mouth in with the thicker silicone. So now I'm just mixing up the second layer of the thin coat. I'm doing the same again as what I did with the first coat. And now we've got a nice print coat or print layer which picks up all those details with no air bubbles. I've just cut out some key plugs there. So we'll use those a little bit in the video. We'll stick them on top of the fish, and that'll match up with our mother mold when we get around to making the mother mold, which I'll make from fiberglass. I was going to make this in a solid block, but because of the shape of the mold, I needed to layer it up with the silicone. I just showed you some thickener, so I'm adding the thickener now to this third batch of silicone. And this consistency is almost like sort of icing sugar, and it's like icing a cake. And between each coat, I've left the silicone to start curing for about an hour, between an hour and 2 hours between each coat. So when you apply each layer, you want to put your finger on the silicone and not have any silicone stick to your finger, so it's sort of beyond that tacky phase. And there I am icing that silicone onto the fish and filling in any recesses and deep areas. The main recess is the mouth. And like I say, just spread the silicone around as if you're going to like icing a cake. So I'm using a spatula there, or tongue press, just to move the silicone where I want it. And just keep moving it around until you get to where you want the silicone to stay. And now I'm just tidying it up with a paintbrush. And once we've done that, we'll leave this for a couple of hours. Of course, on the video, it just jumps straight to the next phase. But yeah, we'll leave it for a couple of hours, and then we'll put another thick coat on, and we'll put the key plugs in, or registration keys, which will mold into the mother mold when we get around to doing the mother mold. So there I'm putting the registration keys in there and just sitting that into the silicone, which I've just put on so it's wet, and that can set into the silicone and wait for an hour or two to put the fourth coat of silicone on, which is another thick coat. So there I'm mixing up the fourth coat with the thickener. And the same process again. So this should give us a nice thick mold. So there we are, just working in those areas with the tongue press or spatula. And over again with the paintbrush, just tidying it up. And we'll finish off by putting a couple of neat layers of silicone over the top of this mold. So that's where we're at the moment. So here's two layers of silicone without the thickener, just as it comes. Mix it up, give it a good mix. Make sure that catalyst is thoroughly mixed into the main part of the silicone. So it goes that pinky color. In this case, it's a red catalyst with a white silicone, so you're aiming for that consistent pink color. And here's the final coat. And like I say, like at the beginning, we just pour that higher and spread that over the top of the mold. And this is our finishing layer. I use a big spatula as well. It's probably better to mix up your silicone with a bigger spatula. It's less work than mixing it with a small spatula. So there we are, that's the final mold, ready for mother molding. And so put the mother mold up, we can trim that up, and once that's all done, it'll look like a nice neat and tidy mold, ready for casting further casts, resin, fiberglass, and even other materials. Thank you very much, and over and out for now.